So regardless of whether you're an amateur builder or a pro builder, there's always one question that we all have in common. What kit am I going to build next? And today we're going to talk about what things to take into consideration when choosing your next kit. So the very first thing we're gonna take into consideration when choosing a kit is gonna be your budget. It doesn't matter if you have a kit already that you really want or if it's a kit that you're considering. If you can't afford it, then you pretty much can't get it. So first things first, set your price range. Gunpla can definitely be a very expensive hobby, but it can also be a relatively cheap hobby. For example, I picked up this high-grade Exia kit for maybe less than $20. Very fun kit, easy to build. But on the other spectrum, there's the perfect grade Exia. Definitely not a cheap kit. I think this without the lighting kit probably costs around $180, but at the same time, still relatively easy to build. So that's a huge price difference between these two model kits. The main differences you'll see are the scale as well as the amount of detail and gimmicks in the kit. And if you want to know more about the differences between the different grades of Gunpla, please stay subscribed and I'll have a video out on that sometime in the near future. But Gunpla kits are not just priced on their grade, they're also priced on the amount of plastic that comes with a kit. For example, like I said, this Exia right here costs maybe between $15 and $20, but this high-grade Messer costs somewhere between $25 and $30. Obviously, it's a chunkier kit, it has more plastic, and it's a little bigger even. So at least it's nice to know that when you pay more for a kit, you're getting a little bit more with it. And so that brings us to our next deciding factor. How much space do you have for a new Gunpla kit? Obviously, high grades are gonna take the smallest amount of space, and they're about the same size as real grade kits. The Messer, as well as some other high grade kits, are a bit of an exception. Then you have the medium sized kits, like this Master Grade Barbatos here. It's a little bigger than the Messer, but it's a good amount bigger than this high-grade Exia. And of course, you have bigger kits like the Perfect Grades. These ones are gonna be some of the biggest model kits you can find. There are even bigger kits as well as busts you can buy, but they'll all take up pretty much the same amount of big space. So if you do plan on building a lot of kits, maybe you should stick with high grades or master grades. But if you're thinking about picking up a kit as a centerpiece, maybe get a perfect grade. Honestly, this kit right here really stands out on my shelf. Not the one behind me, the one over there that you guys never see. So you've got your budget figured out and you know about how much space you'll need for your next model kit. The next thing to take into consideration is what exactly are you interested in Gundam? Maybe there's a favorite anime series you have, be it the original Mobile Suit Gundam, Iron-Blooded Orphans, 8th MS Team, whatever it is, if it's Gundam, there's probably a kit already out for it. Some of my favorite series are Iron-Blooded Orphans as well as Gundam 00. That's why I chose Exia to be my first perfect grade. But we can even go a little deeper into that question, into what types of mobile suits you like. For example, I have one friend who really likes the most boring looking mobile suits. He plays a lot of Warhammer, so he's mostly into painting miniatures, and he really likes the look of mass-produced mobile suits such as Zaku's or the gym units. I have another friend who really likes the more military-themed mobile suits. So mobile suits like the Exia are definitely more hero-themed in a sense. They have that slimmer, human-like proportion, somewhat unrealistic in a way. So that friend actually prefers Universal Century mobile suits. And for me personally, I've actually just finished the Build Divers series and I'm thinking about picking up some more of those kits. The next thing to take into consideration, what's your skill level with building a model kit? If you're brand new, I wouldn't say don't do it, but I would highly suggest buying something like a perfect grade, just because it's a lot of money, and if you don't have that much experience, you are a little more likely to make a mistake on it. So if you're new, I would suggest getting a high grade or even a master grade if you're more confident in your abilities. Eventually, someday, you're gonna have to push the envelope and see if you can handle the next tier up. So if you've been building high grades, maybe you should get a master grade. Or likewise, if you've been building master grades, maybe you should get a perfect grade. And with that skill level begs the question, do you plan on customizing the kit at all? This includes adding additional parts, scribing additional panel lines, or even just painting it. Some Gunpla have a lot more detail than others, even if they're within the same grade. For example, one of the most detailed high grades is the High Grade Moon Gundam. That one gained a lot of popularity when it came out just because it was really detailed for what a high grade usually has. And another form of customization is kit bashing. What kit bashing is essentially taking parts from one kit and adding it onto another kit. This is very easily done with high-grade kits because they usually share the same 3mm peg system. So usually you can take an arm off of one of them and pop it right onto the segment of another. And maybe you play the mobile game Gundam Battle Gunpla Warfare. You could get the exact kits you use to make your mobile suit in that game. And the last thing to take into consideration is what do you plan on doing with a kit once you're finished with it? Do you plan on collecting a bunch of kits? Maybe you need every mobile suit from a specific series, such as all of the Master Grades from the Gundam Wing series. Or maybe you really like all of the Gunpla designed by Hajime Katoki. In that case, you would have to look for all of the Master Grade Verka kits. Maybe you want to work on a specific diorama with a kit you already have. For example, when I bought my Real Grade Zeon, even though I already have 4 different high-grade RX-78-2s, I still bought the real-grade RX-78-2 just to keep the consistency. Likewise, I'm considering getting the Master-grade New Gundam Verka, because I already have the Master-grade Sazabi Verka. Or maybe you're even building a kit just as a commission, which, in that case, I think the buyer should probably be choosing the kit. And one more tip I just remembered, if for whatever reason none of those tips actually helped you choose a new kit, just buy whatever's newest. That's what I've been doing a lot these days, just to 1. Keep up with content, and 2. Also keep up with Bandai's engineering. It's cool to see the new innovations they're doing with newer kits, and sometimes it feels nice just to have the latest and greatest. So those are my tips for you guys. I hope you guys found something helpful out of them. If you are planning on picking up a kit, let me know what kit you're planning on getting down below and how you came to that decision. Likewise, feel free to join the Discord. The link is in the description. In there, you're more than welcome to share your work in progress pictures as well as your collection. So anyways, I'll leave either see you in the Discord or catch you on stream, but for now, go ahead, pick up a kit, and start building.